Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture in the subject Operations Research. And this is lecture number 6.5 in the module 6 Inventory Model. And we are going to discuss, the topic for discussion is Inventory Model with Probabilistic Demand. The solution for the inventory model, and we'll solve few problems in the inventory model with the probabilistic demand. In the earlier 4 lectures, we discussed the deterministic model, inventory model with the deterministic demand, where the demand is known. So, what do you mean by deterministic demand? The demand is known, but practically there is no such a model. So, in a inventory system, inventory model, the required stock level, the demand, the consumption rate is not known well in advance. So, it is varying from time to time, season to season, country to country, and area to area. So, that is what the inventory model with the probabilistic demand. So, here the probability distribution will be given for a given period of time. What is the probability distribution? From that, we have to find out the optimum ordering quantity and optimum time. And the learning outcome to the students at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problem in the probabilistic inventory model. And inventory model with the probabilistic model. In the deterministic inventory model, what we discussed earlier, it is assumed that the demand is known, but in practice, the demand of any item or commodity is not exactly known. And it may be fluctuate. It may fluctuate from time to time, season to season. In such a model, the probability of demand is known as probabilistic model. Then the probabilistic distribution may be discrete or continuous. So, discrete, continuous, if we know the meaning. So, it will be in small quantity or it will be continuously varying with the same trend. So, we take the model number 5, inventory model with the probabilistic demand. Here we are going to discuss 4 different models with the probabilistic demand. Among the 4 different models, first 2 models are very important from the examination point of view. So, the first model, model number 5, the assumptions for the model, instantaneous demand. This demand is instantaneous. So, all of the demand will come, you have to satisfy the demand. If you are not satisfying the demand, you will be losing the business. So, setup cost is 0 because immediately we are purchasing, there is no setup cost. Setup cost is 0, stock level is discrete and lead time is 0. So, these are all the assumptions for the model. We take the parameter. R is the discrete demand rate with the probability PR. IM is the discrete stock level for time interval T. And T is the constant interval between the orders. C1 is the holding cost per item per unit time. And C2 is the shortage cost per item per unit time. And if R is less than IM, so IM is the stock level, R is the demand rate. If R is less than IM, so what do you mean by that? Demand is less and stock level is more. So, demand rate is less than or equal to the stock level on hand. So, there is no shortage. So, some item will be in excess because R is less than IM. So, in that case, the cost of holding the excess item is C1 into IM minus R. IM is the stock level, R is the demand level. So, the excess item will be stored in the business area. So, the cost of holding the excess item is C1 into IM minus R. If R is greater than IM, so we have certain stock, but the demand rate is more. R is the demand rate, which is more. The demand rate is greater than or equal to the stock level on the hand. The shortage will occur. So, in that case, shortage will occur, the cost associated with the shortage. So, that is equal to C2 into R minus IM. Now, what is our, we have to balance between these two. So, if there is a shortage of item, you will be losing some cost. If it is a excess item, you have to hold the item for a certain time. So, holding cost and the shortage cost. So, the total expected cost CIM equal to C1 into sigma of R equal to 0 to IM into IM minus R into PR. So, PR is the probability distribution of the demand plus C2 into sigma R equal to IM plus 1 to I infinity into R minus IM into PR. The optimum value of IM that minimizes total expected cost is calculated by So PR, the probability distribution, less than IMO minus 1. Optimum IM value minus 1 is less than C2 by C1 plus C2 is less than the probability distribution, which is less than IMO. This is the condition. So the optimum level. So using this condition, you can find out the optimal level of the stock. So we take one example, we understand the problem. Example number 12. A television dealer finds that the cost of holding a television in the stock for a week is rupees 60 and the cost of shortage per unit is rupees 140. So what do you mean by the two number? So if you have a excess TV, suppose you have 10 TV per month, but the demand is only 9 TV. So 1 TV will be retained in the stock level. So when you in a week time. So the holding the 1 TV for a week time is rupees 60. On the other hand, if you have a shortage of 1 TV, the cost will be rupees 140. You will be losing rupees 140. So for a particular model, the model of television, the probability distribution of weekly sales is as follows. So what is weekly sales for a first week, second week, third week, fourth week, fifth week, sixth week, and the probability distribution is 0.05, 0.1, 0.2, 0.25, 0.2, 0.15, 0.05. How many units per week should the dealer order? So what is the, so we have the distribution. Every week we have to place the order. So what should be the ordering quantity per week? Now, holding cost C1 equal to rupees 60, shortage cost C2 equal to rupees 140, and the weekly sales, we prepare the, repeat the table again, we calculate the probability distribution is given, and the sigma, the sum of the probability distribution we calculate, 0.05, 0.15, adding with the previous value, 0.35, 0.35 plus 0.25 equal to 0.6, 0.6 plus 0.2 equal to 0.8, 0.8 plus 0.15 equal to 0.95, and adding here, it will be 1.0. This is the sum of the probability. Now, C2 by C1 plus C2 equal to 0.7. So, 0.7 is the cost ratio. 0.7 is the cost ratio. Look at the table again. I repeat the table again. So, the what we calculated earlier in the previous slide, everything is repeated here. So, here what is the ratio? 0.7. What is sum of the probability? So, here I have 0.6. Here I have 0.8. So, now the weekly sales. So, one item, two item, three item, four item, five item, six item. So, if you take three item, the probability is 0.6. If you take four item, the probability is 0.68. Now, our value is 0.7. So, how many item we have to place order? Between 3 and 4. Between 3 and 4. Look at it. PR IMO minus 1 less than C2 divided by C1 plus C2 less than PR less than IMO. So, what is IMO? So, what is this value? 0.7. 0.7 is greater than 0.6 is less than 0.8. So, 0.6 here, 0.8 here. So, the stock level IMO. So, the IMO should be less than 4 and greater than 3. So, the answer, optimum stock level per week equal to 4 item. Now, you take this answer. So, if you have 4 item in your stock yard, right? So, if we have a sales of for the entire for the probability distribution, right? Sometimes we may require 3 items, sometimes we may require 4 items. If you require 4 items, if the demand is 4 items, all the 4 items will be sold. If the demand is 3 item, 1 item will be kept in the storage yard and you have to spend some money for holding the stock. This is the answer to the problem. We take another example to understand the problem. Example number 13. A newspaper boy has the following probability of selling a magazine. So, number of copies sold, 10. If 10 copies are sold, the probability of selling 10 copies is 0.1. The probability of selling 11 copies is 0.15. The probability of selling 12 copies is 0.2. The probability of selling 13 copies is 0.25. The probability of selling 14 copies is 0.3. The cost of a copy is rupees 3. The selling price is 5. He cannot return the unsold magazine. How many copies should he order on a particular day? So, if you purchase 10 copies, selling all the 10 copies, you will get the profit. So if suppose purchase say 10 copies, so selling only 9 copies, one copy he has to retain. So that is what the loss, the loss will be 5 minus 3 equal to 2 rupees. You will see here, holding cost equal to rupees 3 and shortage cost equal to rupees 5 minus 3 equal to 2. Because the selling price is 5, the cost of the copy is 3, so shortage will be 2 rupees. Now again, we take the repeat the table, number of copies sold, probability and sum of the probability, 0.1, 0.1 plus 0.15 equal to 0.25, 0.25 plus 0.2 equal to 0.45, and 0.45 plus 0.25 equal to 0.7, and 0.7 plus 0.3 equal to 1.0, that is the probability table. Now we calculate the ratio, cost ratio, C2 by C1 plus C2 equal to 2 divided by 3 plus 2 equal to 0.4, now we compare. So it is between 0.25 and 0.45. Now C2 by C1 plus C2, so this value is between 0.04 is less than 0.05, greater than 0.025. So number of copies that you have to purchase, right, the IMO stock level is less than 12 and greater than 11. So the optimum number of magazines that he has to purchase every day is only 12. So sometimes one day it will be, we will be selling 12, all the 12, or one day you will be selling only 11 and you will be holding the one copy. It will be a loss because we cannot resell. It will become waste. It will become waste because the day of the magazine is only for a particular week. So after that week or after the day, we cannot sell the, it will become old. This will become old. So it will be a loss to the newspaper boy. So we take another example, example number 14, the probability of monthly sales of an item is given by monthly sales 0 item, 1 item, 2 item, 3 item, 4 item, 5 item, 6 item, and the probabilities also given 0.01, 0.06, 0.25, 0.3, 0.22, 0.1, 0.06. The cost of carrying inventory is rupees 30 per month and the cost of unit shortage is rupees 70. Determine the optimum stock level to minimize the expected cost. So the holding cost is rupees 30 and shortage cost C2 equal to rupees 70 and the table, probability table is repeated here. Sigma PR is calculated 0.01, 0.07, 0.32, 0.62, 0.84, 0.94 and 1.0. And we calculate the cost ratio and repeat the table again. Cost ratio equal to 70 divided by 30 plus 70 equal to 0.7 and this 0.7 is between 0.62 and 0.84. So, C2 by C1 plus C2 and here this 0.7 is greater than 0.62 and less than 0.84 and the stock level, optimum stock level is greater than 3 and less than 4. So, the optimum number of items equal to IMO equal to 4. And next model, model number 6, inventory model with the probabilistic demand and here the instantaneous demand, setup cost is 0 and the stock level is continuous. Earlier the stock level was discrete, now here it is continuous and the lead time equal to 0. And R is the continuous demand with the probability density function f of R into PR. So it is continuously varying, right? So there will be a function, there will be an equation defining the demand. IM is the continuous stock level, C1 is the holding cost per unit per item per unit time and C2 is the shortage cost per item per unit time. Now we calculate the expected cost for oversupply. So this equal to C1 integral 0 to IM minus R into F of R dr. F of R is the function for the demand in terms of function of demand and dr the parameter. Then similarly expected cost of undersupply. So shortage cost C2 into 0 to IM R minus IM into F of R dr. So total expected cost C1 into integral 0 to IM minus R F of R dr plus C2 into integral 0 to IM R minus IM into F of R dr. Now the total expected cost will be minimum if DC by DM equal to 0 and D square C by DM IM square is greater than 0, that is positive. Now doing the performance, differentiating with respect to IM and equating to 0, the optimum level of IM is integral 0 to R equal to 0 to IM F of R dr equal to C2 by C1 plus C2. So when you know the function of the demand, you substitute here, integrate the equation and equal to C2 by C1 plus C2, we'll get the optimum stock level IM. We take an example and understand the procedure, the solution equation. Example number 15, a baking company sells one of its type of cake by weight. If the product is not sold on the day it is baked, it can be sold only for a loss of 15 pence per kg, and there is a unlimited market for one day of old cake. The company makes a profit of rupees 95 pence on every kg of the cake sold on the day it is baked. The past daily orders forms a triangular distribution with the density function f of x equal to 0.02 minus 0.0002x. So this is the probability distribution function. Now we have to calculate the optimum stock level. So the holding cost is 15 pence, so rupees 0.15. The shortage cost is 95 pence because we will be losing 95. The profit is 95 pence. We will be losing 95 pence if the product is not sold on the particular day. So 95 pence, 0.95 rupees 0.95, and the probability density function f of x equal to 0.02 minus 0.002x. Now the optimum value of IM. So integral 0 to IM f of r dr C2 by C1 plus C2. So doing the substituting for f of x, r equal to 0 to IM, 0.02 minus 0.002x into dx C2 by C1 plus C2. So integrating 0.02x minus 0.002x square by 2, r equal to 0 to IM, 0.95 divided by 0.15 divided by plus 0.95. So right hand side is 0.95 divided by 1.1. So here substituting the r equal to 0, the second part becomes 0, the first part 0.02 IM minus 0.001 IM square, because 2 in 2 it is cancelled, this becomes 0.001 IM square equal to 0.95 divided by 1.1. Cross multiplying, you will get a quadratic equation, 1.1 in 10 power minus 4 IM square minus 0.022 IM plus 0.95 equal to 0. So solving the quadratic equation, IM equal to 0.02 plus or minus square root of 0.022 square minus 4 into 1.1 into 10 power minus 4 into 0.95 divided by 2 into 1.1 into 10 power minus 4. So numerator will be 0.022 plus or minus 8.124 into 10 power minus 3 divided by 2.2 into 10 power minus 4. So the IM will be either 140 or 63. So the optimum value of IM equal to 63 kg. So every day they have to prepare the cake for 63 kilogram. Model number 7, inventory model with a probabilistic demand. The assumptions for the model are continuous demand, setup cost is 0, stock level is discrete, and lead time equal to 0. So R is the demand rate with the probability DR, IM is the discrete stock level for a time interval, T is the constant interval between the orders, C1 is the holding cost per item per unit time, and C2 is the shortage cost per item per unit time. So when IM is less than, when R is less than IM, the holding cost for the excess quantity, so C1 into IM minus R by 2 into T. And when R is greater than IM, the holding cost due to the under supply, so C1 the C1 into IM square T divided by 2R plus C2 into R minus IM whole square into T divided by 2R. The total expected cost is sigma C equal to sigma R equal to 0 to IM C1 into IM minus R by 2 into T into PR plus sigma R equal to IM plus 1 to infinity C1 IM square into T divided by 2R plus C2 into R minus IM whole square T by 2R into PR. So the cost will be minimum when the following condition is satisfied. So the C2 by C1 plus C2 is the cost ratio when the cost ratio is greater than this equation. So this IM sigma IR equal to 0 to IM PR plus IM minus 1 by 2 into sigma IM plus 1 to the infinity PR by R is less than C2 by C1 plus C2 is less than sigma R equal to 0 to IM PR plus plus IM plus 1 by 2 into sigma IM plus 1 into the to infinity into PR by R. When this condition is satisfied, so stock level will be optimum. Inventory model, model number 8, inventory model with the probabilistic demand. The assumptions for the model are continuous demand, setup cost is 0, stock level is continuous and lead time equal to 0. So, R is the continuous demand with the probability density function, F of R PR, IM is the continuous stock level, C1 is the holding cost per item per unit time and C2 is the shortage cost per item per unit time. And the expected cost for oversupply equal to C1 integral 0 to IM, IM minus R by 2 into F of R DR, and the shortage cost due to the undersupply. So, IM integral IM to infinity C1 into IM square by 2R plus C2 into R minus IM whole square by 2R into F of R DR. And the total expected cost is calculated by adding the two values C equal to C1 into integral 0 to IM, IM minus R by 2 into F of R DR plus integral IM to infinity C1 IM square by 2R plus C2 into R minus IM whole square by 2R into F of R DR. The total cost will be minimum if dc by dm equal to 0 and d square c by dim square is greater than 0. So, differentiating with respect to im and equating to 0, the optimal level of im is 0 integral 0 r equal to 0 to im f of r dr plus integral r equal to im to infinity im into f of r by r into dr equal to c2 by c1 plus c2. So, when this condition is satisfied, you will get the optimum stock level and the cost will be optimum. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I have written in mechanical engineering subject, and you may find one book, Operation Research. You can refer to the book for additional information in the subject. I upload the video lectures of all the subjects in the YouTube channel. You subscribe the channel, use the videos for your better learning. Thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box in the YouTube channel. Contact me for any clarification on the subject. So, we'll meet again with another video lecture in the inventory model. Until then, bye-bye.